Hi, I'm Sukant Deepak from Ions TV, and today we have Mr. Muzaffar Ali with us. Thank you so much for joining us.
Thank you.
It's such a pleasure having you over.
So, sir, when you talk about Anjuman E Dil, which is going to be organized in Delhi, so could you please tell me how it was conceived and what was the trigger behind it?
Basically, it's about sharing poetry.
Yes.
And sharing poetry through music.
Mm-hmm.
Then sharing poetry which touches me, which drives me. So we've had a couple of shows earlier, but now we are looking at it as an entire season of six evenings, you know.
Mm-hmm.
And it's on Khayyam Shanasi.
Okay.
Shanasi means knowing, coming to know.
Mm-hmm.
Like Khusro Shanasi means knowing Khusro, coming to know, getting to know Khusro. So basically it's about coming to know Khayyam.
Right.
Because he's worked with me on four films.
Okay.
And each film has given both of us a new kind of dimension to music and poetry and compositions, you know. So I think he's a guy who really got into the poetry. He got into the poetry and he got into the audience also. So he could feel the poetry from an audience point of view.
Right.
And so the experiences I've had with him in my few films that I've made, particularly Anjuman in Umrao Jaan and Zuni, which was supposed to be done in Kashmir.
Mm-hmm.
I've recorded the songs.
Okay.
So basically it's about how the music came out, you know, how we created the music together. Then after that we are going into Fez. Fez has also been a part of my life. I've used a lot of his poetry in my films.
Right.
I've made a short film on Fez also.
Mm-hmm.
And he's, I think, one of the most relevant people in, I would say, the subcontinent.
Even now?
Yeah, in the contemporary world.
Mm-hmm.
Then after that, we are looking at poets of Aligarh.
Mm-hmm.
Aligarh also has been a very important part of my gaining consciousness, gaining creative sense, understanding the world, and understanding the world through poetry and poetry through the world. So this was an important learning process, and I've used Shahryar in most of my films. So this is going to be Shahryar, and then Rahi Masoom Raza also has been part of my creative awakening. So we'll have him, and then Khalilur Rahman Azmi.
Okay.
So these are the poets that created a kind of a new Muzaffar Ali, you know, as far as I'm concerned. Then after that we'll have Amir Khusro, because we do this festival called Jahan-e-Khusro, and how I have woken up to my spiritual self through Amir Khusro.
Okay.
This self which yearns for surrender, submission. So that was Khusro. And then we'll move on to Rumi. Rumi also has been a part of my awakening, of my creative expression. How much it's gone to the people, I don't know, but at least let me share it with a few people with taste and who are close to us. Then I was planning one on Wajid Ali Shah.
Okay.
We do a Wajid Ali Shah festival in Lucknow. So I think Wajid Ali Shah also has been a very important person in my life. I've done a serial called Jaane Alam on Wajid Ali Shah, in which I acted as Wajid Ali Shah myself. Then we've done a lot of plays around Wajid Ali Shah or by Wajid Ali Shah, using his tumris and ghazal. In my film Jaane Sar, I've used two poems of his. So there'll be one on Wajid Ali Shah. So this is going to be this season.
Okay. So talking to you, it's tough not to mention Umrao Jaan and Gaman. And what strikes is the powerful women characters in those films and all your films. So any special reason behind it?
See, women become a very important part of understanding culture, understanding exploitation, understanding intellect. You know, so I think women, because of my mother and because of maybe the women I've had, my wife Meera, and even before I've been married, so they're very strong women. And so women take you deep into the world, you know, and give you a lot of inner strength.
And how do you look at contemporary Bollywood?
I think it's good. Contemporary Bollywood is very good. Except that I think the audience is growing differently now. They want things loud with a lot of harsh language to wake people up, you know. So let's say, I mean, things are changing as always. There is good and there's bad. And Bollywood is Bollywood, you know.
As we were just talking, you know, that now we are also seeing a shift in the sense that there's little difference between mainstream and alternate. And we are witnessing directors from across the country, you know, talking in the language of the soil. So how do you comment on such films?
I think films are becoming more conversational, they're becoming more commonplace, and they're becoming more user-friendly. Because it's very important. Now it's, you've gone away from the big screen, the single screen, which demanded a lot of larger-than-life things, you know what I mean?
Right.
Then we've gone into multiplexes, which are also, and I think, on the fade out, you know, because real estate is expensive. So now people are looking at things at their own home. A lot of industry has gone into creating screens which can be seen in your own comfort, you know, of your own house. And then you have the telephone, the mobile, which takes things to to your pocket all the time, you know. I think the medium is becoming more user friendly. You can shoot faster, cheaper, better. So, but eyeballs are eyeballs, you know, you need stars to get the eyeballs.
Thank you so much for your time. It was such a pleasure speaking to you, sir. Thank you.